Good morning, children. Once again, a warm welcome to the online classes for 7th standard. As I'm handling social subject for 7th standard in the online class, so today we are going to see and learn more about the dynasties which ruled our Karnataka. So as in the previous lesson, I have explained you about the Vijayanagar Empire. Now, in this lesson, that is Bahmani Adil Shah. So here, this Muslim dynasty which ruled our southern part of India, that is Karnataka region, what are their contributions? What are their services done towards the art and literature? So today we are going to take a deep discussion towards that dynasties. As in the history of Karnataka, previous Vijayanagar Empire was established in 1336 CE. So later on, 3rd August of 1347, means after the decline or after the downfall of Vijayanagar Empire, here the new Muslim dynasty started to arrive or exist, that is Bahmani Empire. So here it established on 3rd August 1347 CE. So here you have to know about Alauddin Hasan Gangu Burman Shah. Once again, I'll repeat, Alauddin Hasan Gangu Burman Shah was the founder of this empire, that is Bahmani Adil Shah's empire. So as we can see, battles were taking place continuously between Bahmani Sultans and the Vijayanagar kings. So here we can see inner conflicts or somewhat confusions or somewhat strategies were going on in the dynasty. By 1527, here we can see this Bahmani Adil Shahs have been divided into five Shah dynasties. As we can see, among them, Adil Shahis of Vijayapura were prominent. Prominent means they were superior. So main achievements of sultans of this Shah dynasties or this dynasty we are going to discuss in this lesson, and we are also going to see their service or their contribution towards literature and sculpture. Not only that, here we can see moreover the achievements of Sultan Firoz Shah, so who is the famous prime minister. And not only that, Muhammad Gawan, who is also working or who has done his service as the prime ministers to this Adil Shahis, were main roles played in this dynasties. So with this, here we can see Bahmani dynasties got more and more fame by the effort of these two people only. As if you see, when Vijayanagar Empire was founded in the northern part, so here when this Vijayanagar Empire was in the northern part of it, Bahmani Empire was also founded after this decline of Vijayanagar Empire in 1347. So here you should see its founder was Alauddin Hasan Gangu. So it may be asked for bits or it will be asked for one mark questions. Here, who is the founder of Bahmani Shah dynasties? Here you have to remember well. Here the main founder of this Bahmani dynasty was Alauddin Hasan Gangu Burman Shah. So this Burman Shah was working in the army of Delhi Sultans. So this Burman Shah, who is working as in the army of Delhi Sultans, of the name of that sultan is Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So here this Burman Shah was working as a prime minister in the service of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. So now we'll move towards the deep conclusion or deep discussion towards this Bahmani Sultans. So as you can see, they gave their services from 1347 to 1527 CE. So So what is the main role they have played is, as this Bahmani state had the parts of Karnataka like Maharashtra and Andhra Pradesh, Telangana states under its rule. So these Bahmani states or Bahmani sultans, Bahmani dynasty, which is having in their region as Karnataka, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh under their rule. So in the beginning, Kalburgi and later Bidar was made as their capital cities. Not only that, here Bahmani Empire was in the northern part of Krishna River and Vijayanagar Empire was in the southern part of Krishna River. So and here we can see Tajuddin Firoz Shah. Who is he? Tajuddin Firoz Shah was a great sultan in the Bahmani dynasty. So now we'll have a deep sight towards Tajuddin Firoz Shah. So who is this Tajuddin Firoz Shah? He is the prominent ruler of Shahi dynasties. As this Tajuddin Firoz Shah, so as he gave his contribution towards from 1397 to 1422. So as you can see, he was very liberal, judicious and a believer of God. Tajuddin Firoz Shah, who is very liberal, judicious and a believer of God, means in his administration he used to judge the people according to their characters, according to their according to their belief. Why? Means moreover, he is also a good believer of God. So he made copies of Quran and edited it for whole life. As he was a writer, encouraged all languages, and he was also an expert in geometry and theology also. And not only that, he sheltered many philosophers, poets, artists, and had honored them with pleasure also. Not only that, he established an observatory, means he established an observatory in Daulatabad, which is in now present Maharashtra. Not only that, he propagated the beauty of his capital, Kalburgi, and he built a new city called Firozabad, so which is built on the bank of Bhima River. And not only that, he gifted many villages to Sufi saints, so who are not only connected towards this worldly things, only their concentration will be towards Allah only. To such people or some Muslims, they'll concentrate or they'll spend their whole life towards the service of Allah. And some Hindus, they'll spend their lifetime in the service of God only. So here he gifted many villages to Sufi saints. Not only that, Bande Nawaz, who arrived to the kingdom of this Shahi dynasties during his period, during Tajuddin Firoz Shah's period, and he concentrated on the development of ports, means here through the ports only, as we can see, tourism, foreign tourism was encouraged at the time of Tajuddin Firoz Shah also. And here one more person who gave his service as a prime minister is Muhammad Gawan. So as this Muhammad Gawan, so who appointed as a prime minister and in the region of 1463 to, and he gave his service up to 1481. So all the credit of making Bahmani dynasty goes only to Muhammad Gawan. So for the namesake, he may be the prime minister, but basically he has got a good strength to make over this dynasty. Not only that, he was a Persian and he worked honestly as the prime minister in the region of Sultans of Muhammad Shah III also. As if you see, important factors about Muhammad Gawan was, as being the prime minister, he worked his effort as being he is the king of that Shahi dynasties. And here we can see Muhammad Gawan captured Hubballi, Belagavi and Goa from Vijayanagar Empire. Not only that, administration was according to the Islamic laws. Means here the head of this dynasty belongs to Muslim religion. So here administration was going according to the Islamic laws only. Not only that, here Muhammad Gawan encouraged revenue and postal services. And here not only that, whatever Gawan do, he will do for the betterment of the dynasty, thinking like that whole powers was given to him. And he fixed taxes on the basis of land's fertility. So if the land is not got good fertility, and this year the farmer has not got good crops, so no need to pay any tax to the kings. Like that he fixed some tax on the basis of land fertility and irrigation facility. If the farmer is having sufficient supply of water, so he can do the agriculture work and he can pay tax to the government or the kings who are ruling at that time. Not only that, he removed some taxes which were annoying the people. Here we can see number of laws were made, but only that laws will be followed by the prime minister, and the prime minister under him some officials will be there, so they have to look after the betterment of the people in the administration of that dynasty's king or the queen. But here some people are misusing the taxes and they are annoying or they are making harassment on the people. So here Muhammad Gawan removed some taxes which are very annoying to the people. So not only that, as a philosopher, here Muhammad Gawan himself founded or constructed madrasas, means universities, in Bidar for the orphan people. Not only that, he encouraged Islamic religion and law education. Not only that, he introduced astronomy, mathematics and history were being studied there in the madrasas. And here in the madrasas, free education and hostel facility, means people who are coming, students who are coming from other than that state, so they can have accommodation there in the madrasas. So for them, free education and hostel facilities were there. Around 3000 manuscripts, means reference books, were there in the library of madrasa, which was established by Muhammad Gawan. Not only that, Muhammad Gawan contributed a lot in making the Bahmani kingdom great. So regional leaders were natural. Here, if someone is doing good for the society, and some people will be there who will be feeling very jealous that this person will get more popularity by doing all such things. So here in the life of Muhammad Gawan also we can observe regional leaders, means local leaders, are jealous of his fame and conspired, means they made one plan to kill or to murder this Muhammad Gawan. As you can see on the tomb of Gawans, it is written that innocent Gawan was killed. So when Gawan was murdered, so he has not committed any mistake, any sin, but some people who are jealous towards his fame, so planned and killed Muhammad Gawan. So here this shows that till today also we can see people who wants to do betterment for the society, so here all will not support to that person. And if you see the cultural contributions of this Bahmani sultans or Shahi dynasties, here if you see education, here Bahmani sultans encouraged Islamic education, means at that time, as being the Muslim religion and that sultan belongs to Muslim community, so here Bahmani sultans encouraged Islamic education, and the chanting of Quran was the part of the education. So not only that, Kalburgi, Bidar, Ilachipur and Daulatabad and other were the Islamic educational centers during this region. Not only that, here poor people and orphans, particularly poor people and orphans, were provided free food and shelter. And not only that, scholarships were given to the students in madrasas. So after completing their education, if they get a good percentage, as nowadays we are getting year after year scholarships, no, So like that, at that time only here, Bahmani sultans provided free and shelter, food and shelter to the students who will stay back in the madrasas. Not only that, Quran philosophy means as whatever policies written in the Quran and principles of Sufism were taught in the schools. Not only that, if you see the literary works, means how was the work, means when you see what type of literature they used to take is literary activities were greatly encouraged by Bahmani sultans, and not only that, they sheltered many philosophers, poets and writers. Not only that, Firoz Shah, Muhammad Shah II and Muhammad Gawan were also the writers and minister poets also. Means double job they used to do at the time of war. So they used to do the wars and expand their kingdom. And in the leisure time, they used to encourage and they used to involve themselves in the poetry section. During this region, Persian, Arabic and Urdu literatures were developed. Not only that, great Sufi saints and writer Bande Nawaz belong to this period also. So here, the language that they and other foreigners used to become famous as Dakkani language. So later, it developed as Urdu language. And if you see the sculptures, so here, the history of Bahmani dynasty is famous for sculpture and architecture. Means the type of monuments they were built. So here shows that a particular style of building the constructing the buildings. The monuments in Bidar, Kalburgi and other places are in the Hindu-Islam style. Means as if you observe. So here on the top of that monument, here you can see of sculpture we can observe. Means this shows that the resemblance of Hindu and Islam style, and it is familiar as Dakkani style also. So here the first contribution of Burmanis is Jamia Masjid of Kalburgi district, and Muhammad Shah built it. So here this Jamia Masjid was built by Muhammad Shah at Kalburgi. So here the meeting hall with the small domes was the main attraction here. Not only that, tombs of sultans are also in Kalburgi, and they were also domed constructed in domed structures only. Not only that, the tomb of Bande Nawaz is another prominent monument in Kalburgi. Not only that, here Bidar's Sola Kamba Mosque and beautiful palaces in the fort are famous sculptures contributed by this Shahi dynasties. Not only that, these buildings are decorated and have carved wooden crafts on them. Means if you observe that monument, you'll come to know what type of technique they have used. Not only that, here 12 tombs of Ashtar near Bidar are also famous monuments constructed at the time of Bahmani sultans. So here the prominent monument of the Bahmani kingdom is Madrasa, which was built by Minister Muhammad Gawan. So it is nearly 242 wide and 222 feet long. And in that we can see 56 feet height and three-storied building. So this building is more than 5 centuries old, appears to be declaring its glory. So if those who are having textbooks, they can refer about this, the monument constructed by Muhammad Gawan. So here, up to this, we have come across about the Bahmani sultans, in that Tajuddin, Firoz Shah and Muhammad Gawan, who gave their contribution towards Bahmani kingdom. Not only that, here if you observe Shah dynasties, means after getting conflicts or some inner conflicts which made this Bahmani sultans to divide into five. So about them we are going to discuss in the next class. Until then, have a good day.